Jain, welcome to Computology Academy, and today we are going to discuss about the recent wave of migration or exodus of the migrant laborers from the cities towards their native village. So why this is going on, we will discuss later on, and we will see the related questions that may be asked in the UPSC and other civil services exam. So do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload new videos, and watch the video till the end to get clarified about the various issues that are related with the migrant laborers and the recent exodus of the migrant laborers from the cities towards their native village that has started again after this second wave of corona. So the second wave of corona has started because of the double mutation of the corona strand genomics that has been recently discovered, and for that we have made a video. You can go to the playlist and you can watch that also. So the second wave of corona has started, and it is more potent or more infectious than the earlier strands and the vaccines that has been developed, that is for the earlier version of corona, and it may not be that much therapeutically effective against the new strands or the mutated strands of corona. Because of this, there has been again the rate of infection has increased. Per day cases are going on increasing day by day, and the rate of death has also increased. So because of that, what has happened, the migrant laborers are again moving from the city towards their villages. So these migrant laborers are moving towards their villages again from the city. And why is this happening? This is not because of the economic or the social issues, but the religious issues. So here the discussion starts. They are not losing their economic stability even after this recent wave. Earlier there was lockdown, they had lost their jobs, they were in the need of money, food and other livelihood necessities, but the government was looking after, they were supplying the food and the other related necessary things to sustain their life. But then also they had migrated from the cities towards their villages. But this time what happened? This time they are not losing their jobs. Job is as it is, that is intact, because the lockdowns are occasional. There are night curfews. The lockdown is not complete and most of the industries are operational. But still the laborers are moving towards their villages. This is not because they are in economic stress. As earlier also, if you see that the migration in 2020 April, when the lockdown, after the first lockdown, when some lockdown was relaxed and they were allowed to move towards their villages, this migration was not because of economic hardship, but this migration was because, although they were migrating towards their villages, you know that the village condition, the family condition of the people who had migrated to the cities is not that much good. Otherwise, they would not have migrated to the city in the search of job or to earn money, because they don't have that good economic condition at the village. Because of that, they have migrated to the cities to earn the money and to support their family back at village. But still they were migrating back to their village when they were facing the hardship of lockdown and the related infection and is deaths. So this was because they were fearful that they will die alone. So if they die alone, so what is the issue? If they die alone, there will be nobody to perform their last rites, their rituals, to cremate them in the process which is their tradition, and this will be leading to not getting the moksha or the transition of their soul from this world to the eternal world, and they will be wandering, their soul will be wandering here and there. This is the fear. So the migration is because of the religious issue. In here you can see that this is the recent picture of the Mumbai railway station where the migrant laborers have gathered to get back to their village, and this is because of that religious issue. Because right now there is not that much of harsh lockdown in the cities that was earlier in 2020. You can see one example. In 1994, there was plague in Surat, and about 6 lakh migrant laborers got back to their home. And this, there was no lockdown, there was no loss of job, there was nothing, no economic hardship. Still, 6 lakh laborers got back to their home, and this was because of this religious issue. So the religion is the most effective thing here, that is creating this exodus from the cities towards the village, that is back migration. And this is the reason that in the Hindus, if you consider, there are rituals that some Hindus are cremated while some are buried. But if the administration finds a dead body of a person for whose body there is no claimant, and because of that the administration will have to cremate him or do the last rituals. But if he is a Hindu, then definitely the administration will cremate him. They will not look after whether his tradition is to bury him or to cremate him. And these rituals are just cremation, and not thereafter they do their chautha or therma or whatever it is. And these things were done, and these things will be done only by their immediate family members, and no other person is going to take such kind of responsibilities. Why? If you consider in the Muslim families, they are given a last bath after the death, and thereafter they are buried, and these things are done by their immediate family members. So this is also not being done by the administration in the proper manner. So these fears that they will stuck, their soul will stuck in the world, and their soul will be wandering in this world, this is the largest fear because of which this migration starts. Otherwise, you know that laborers are not from the so economically well family background, and because of that, what happens if they will get back to villages, then there is already economic distress, so who is going to support them? But this is not the case in the middle class families. In the middle class families, what happens, they are a bit economically well, and if some person gets back to their family, they will get some kind of support. But this is not the case in the poor classes, and they hear what happens, they move back to the villages just because of the religious issue, not because of the economic issue. The middle class family and the upper class family people may get back to their home because of the economic support they will get from their family, but this is not the case with the poor peoples. The poor peoples are basically having the religious issue and the social issue because of which they are getting back to their villages. And they are fearful of dying alone, and if they will die alone, there will be nobody to do their last rites, and because of that, their soul will be wandering in the world. They will not have a proper transition from the earthly world to the heavenly world, and this is the fear because of which they are migrating towards their villages, not the economic condition. So here you can see that most of the laborers who are getting back to their villages are the males. So from the villages, the migration towards the cities is male dominated. So the females remain at the villages, okay? And the dependents, females and the dependents remain in the villages, while the males come to the city to support their families back at village. But in the case of distress, economic distress, they do not get back to the village because they are already not so wealthy or economically so strong that they can support these people. So they are fearful of dying alone and not getting the last rites done properly, and because of which their soul will be wandering here and there in this world, and they will not be transited to the heavenly world, and because of this fear they get back to the villages not to get the economic support. In case of the middle class families and the higher class families, the issue is different. There they can sustain their dependents, they can sustain some people through their family income, but here the case is different. Here the case is only that they are fearful of dying alone and not for the economic support they are getting back to the village. So this is the issue because of which again there has been exodus of the migrant laborers from the big cities towards their villages after this second wave of corona. This is more infectious. This vaccine which has been developed, it is not so much therapeutically effective against this new mutated strand of the coronavirus, and because of that, because of dying alone, these migrant laborers are getting back to their villages. So this was the issue in Mains. You may be asked the question about discuss the reasons because of which during the lockdown or during the second wave the migrant laborers were getting back to their villages, whether it was economic, whether it was social, whether it was religious. So such kind of questions may be asked in the Mains and in other civil services exams. Thank you very much and have a nice day, and do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload new videos. And for what is the double mutation of the coronavirus, you may go to the playlist and watch the video. Thank you very much.